Hi, I'm Jan Allen. I'm a contemporary conceptual artist. Primarily, my work is therapeutic for me. I start with a place, look for my inspiration inside my personal world, and create work from there, just trying to understand perhaps or work through an issue or a process or a situation. And then I look for that place where it's no longer personally about me, but the work takes the leap to talk about us collectively. I'm preparing for a big show called Arrhythmia. I've been working on heart art for a couple of years now. Originally stemmed from, I believe, trying to heal my own broken heart after divorce and upheavals in my life and life changes situations. I have a big projected image that I'm going to hang down here in a piece called Transmigration 842. It's projected images of the sea through these layers of translucent mesh. But depending on where you shift your perception as you either walk through it, look at it, it gives the illusion of, well, for me, I called it transmigration, and that the Buddhist notion of life after life after life, life that you don't destroy energy, it just transforms into other perceptions and dimensions. At the time, it was in reference to my sister Marjorie's passing. She had metastasized breast cancer to the brain. This is a mask that they made to fit over her face and clamp down to the table. And they'd line up on these marks where the laser light would go. And poor gal, she's there caged in, and I'm going, what is this material? My work is about transition and how to move through one place to another and witnessing that transition and that process, whether that's change, movement, growth, development, healing, whatever you'd call it, and then arriving at another place of being, whether that's an ultimate port or not, just a different bookmark in time. A wonderful woman named Araceli Ortega was in Honduras, 24-year-old mother, single mother, diagnosed with a congenital heart defect, and they gave her 2 months to live. No one in Honduras would touch her case. Her boss, who was a general practitioner, decided that, you know, this woman can't die. And he went out of his way to find somebody, somewhere, that would perform surgery and help her out, save her life. Dr. Marks, New Hanover Regional Medical Center, volunteered their services, time, energy, money, whatever, at the hospital. And in May, Araceli came and was operated on and stayed with us and several other people in the community. I was very inspired and moved by her whole story. And in the context of my heart art, gave it a real dimension and depth, and moved the work to a place that was no longer about the peripheral of bypassing the heart, but about going right to that core. She had an aneurysm about the size of a grapefruit on her aorta, which they totally rebuilt, new valves, the works. Amazing, just amazing. And she just touched so many hearts, and she's with us, Araceli. She's gone back now, but she's right here, heart art. I view this also, I put out a call to art to the community to contribute anything that they would like to contribute that relates to the theme of heart, however they want to interpret it. But I'm excited about that community piece of folks getting really excited about being part of a collective. Maybe something will inspire somebody in some way or bring awareness to some aspect, or if nothing else, at least find our collectivity. So that's where the viewer, the audience, somebody experiencing the work adds to the work. It makes it bigger than, it's not about me, it's not about my story, it's not about my experience, my drama. It's about, okay, I did this kind of stuff, I'm having a voice about it, but it's like sitting down and having a conversation with you, and that's what we can talk about, because to talk about ourselves is too personal. To talk about the work gives you a focused place to take it someplace else.
I'm delighted to have a chance to talk about Jan Allen. We met at Dreams when she first moved to Wilmington, and I told her about Acme Art and convinced her that she really needed to come and maybe rent a studio here. And then it turns out that we do work that is almost interchangeable, except that she's better than I am.
The way she's included a lot of people in the artwork, so it looks like a really heartfelt no pun intended, piece of work.
When I came in, on many levels, I think I was very pleasantly surprised, and I had been looking forward to this show for a long time. because we don't have that many installation artists in this area. So, you know, she has several different pieces, between smaller sort of assemblage pieces to her larger scale installation, which is the focus of the show. And I think that's where the meat of the show really lies, is in her large scale installations, which you know, have three-dimensional elements combined with video projection elements. And I think that's what's especially interesting. In addition to that, I think Jan's really brought in a lot of enthusiasm into our local art scene, actually. And I think all of ACME, in fact, has been very excited about the work that she's doing, because, again, we don't have that many installation artists.
Jan's work was really surprising to me. It was, I thought it might be a little bit bloody since it is about the heart, but it was actually really beautiful, really lyrical, really almost spiritual.
Yeah, this is so exciting. I mean, ACME's just full of folks. People are here because they heard it on the radio or heard it somewhere on the bus around town, and just wanted to be part of that, and this is so cool.
I actually had zero expectations coming to the show, because I had no idea what it was about other than something related to the heart. And now being here, I think it's pretty interesting how a lot of it's pretty deconstructed. It seems to have a lot to do with, like, the broken heart, the deconstructed heart, the cage of the heart. So it's pretty cool.
Jan Allen is a gift to Wilmington. I have not been as excited as I am about this exhibition in a long time. I think it's brilliant. It's so Jan. The idea of heart art is something that she and I have been talking about for a long time. She's been very inspired by this idea, this concept, and it's very much her show, but it's also a collaboration. And I love that she invited so many artists to show work with her, and people helping people is the future. It's very exciting. It's a breath of fresh air, and I'm so glad that she's in Wilmington.
My heart is full. That's it. Tomorrow, a big breath. But for today, it's an adrenaline rush. It's being fed by, like, everybody here, all these folks. You know, there were, I don't know if anybody clicked when they came in the door, but I think there were hundreds.
I may never be done with hard art. None of us, maybe.
That hit a chord. Okay, that's how, okay, this is process.
I may never be done with the hard art.
There you go. So anyway, the show was a bookmark in time.